As we reported, yeah, no irony, right? Thanks, all right. As we reported earlier, federal district judge Thomas Penfield Jackson ruled Monday that software giant Microsoft, in fact, violated antitrust laws. What does this mean for the future of the company? What does this mean for consumers? Here now, senior economics fellow at the Brookings Institute in Washington, D.C., Jacob Silge.
Thank you, Colin. Colin, as you know, Judge Jackson ruled that Microsoft violated the Sherman Antitrust Act in no fewer than 3 instances.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God is right, Colin. This ruling is very, very significant.
No, I mean, could you please not shout like that?
Listen, Colin, I have a disease. I suffer from voice immodulation. I'm unable to control the volume or inflection of my voice. This is not shouting, it is talking.
It's just, couldn't you take a deep breath, lower your voice?
How dare you? I cannot do that. I have an affliction that is recognized by the American Medical Association and its British counterpart. Every year, as many as 6 people are stricken by this horrible, horrible disease. It could strike anyone at any time, provided they were born at least 2 months late and have been exposed to gold dust.
Gold dust, Jacob?
Oh, it's funny to you. Imagine, if you will, Colin, a life in which you hold your baby daughter in your arms and try to ease her back to sleep. Hush, hush, go to sleep. Daddy loves you. Or imagine you're at church whispering a secret and silent prayer to God. Oh, please, dear God, why have you done this to me? I hate you, God. Please take away this terrible affliction and also let me find a bag of money. That is my hell, Colin. I wouldn't wish it on anyone. Maybe on you, Colin, but no one else.
Hey, that's mean.
I apologize. That last part was actually muttered under my breath. But I can't mutter under my breath, can I? You jerk. That was under my breath. Also, you ass.
Just stop.
Under my breath again.
Will you stop, Jacob?
I think I will, Colin. I think I will.
Jacob Silge, everybody. I'm Colin Quinn. That's my story. I'm sticking to it. Ilion Gonzalez.